we are one in highlighted mission and vision, instilling excellence in electrical profession. Having a dynamic professional association. Making innovative contributions to our nation.
Now let's continue to series parallel circuits. This is not so very hard because series parallel combination is just a combination of all advantages and disadvantages also of a series at the same time parallel circuits. Kung unsay advantage sa series, unsay advantage sa parallel, giusa na nato diri sa series parallel. Kung unsay disadvantage sa series, o unsay disadvantage sa parallel, giusa po na nato diri sa ato series parallel. But question is, what is the difference between series parallel and parallel series combination? So when to use the word series parallel and when to use parallel series combination. Okay, so we have here. A circuit that contains both series and parallel combination, that is a series parallel. It may be defined as a network in which some portions of the circuit have the characteristic of a simple series circuit and other portions have the simple characteristic of a simple parallel circuit. Okay, so kung saan ito siya tawagon og series parallel? When a combinational circuit, which when simplified will result to a series circuit. So, kana mo lang yung timanan ha. Anyway, di kwan masad na. Para ma-differentiate lang nato. Kung doon na tayo circuit nga ga-combine o series o parallel combination, kanya, ang ato da yung i-simplify. Pag human gani na itong simplify, ang resulta gani sa atong simplified circuit is a series combination. Then, that is a series parallel combination. So, just to give you an idea what is a parallel series, of course, opposite, no? So, kung doon na tayo combinational circuit, unya atong i-simplify, unya ang resulta dayon parallel circuit, then ang ato ang circuit, gitawag na to na siya og parallel series. But take note that whether it is a series parallel circuit or parallel series circuit, and the advantage and the disadvantage of a series, and similarly to the parallel, are just within that circuit. So, good na din sa series resistance in series parallel circuit. So, what is the resistance of the series parallel circuit? Kaya nga nung gitawag ni siya og series parallel, kini nga tong circuit nga gihatag dire. As you can see here, you have the R1 here, we have the parallel combination of R2, R3, and R4. Okay? So, series dayoning parallel combination sa atong resistor 5. So, nga nung gitawag ni siya og series circuit, a series parallel circuit, because what you are going to do here, you have to combine all these three resistors here connected in parallel, R2, R3, and R4. And the combination of R2, R3, and R4, series na to sa ato ang R1, series na to sa atong R2. So, ang sinitabo na to, ang ato ang resulting combined sa circuit is a simple series combination of R1, of the simplified parallel R2, R3, and R4 and series with R5. So muna siyang hinungdan nga nung gitawag na siya og series parallel circuit. Okay, this parallel combination is in series with R1 and R2 as we said, and this is now our formula of the total resistance. It is just equal to R1 plus the simplified R2, R3, R4 parallel circuit plus the series plus, because it is in series with R5. So this is your total resistance. Usubon ako, you have to determine first the total resistance of this parallel combination, then idugang na to sa R1, idugang na to sa R5. That is how you're going to solve for the total resistance. So therefore, we have this series of steps that we have. First, for having series parallel, reduce the original circuit to single equivalent circuit. redrawing the circuit in each step of the reduction of simple series and simple parallel parts are reduced to single equivalent resistors. Solve for the total resistance and then solve for the total current using Ohm's law. Then number four, determine the equivalent resistor voltage drops, okay, and branch currents one stage at a time, working backwards to the original circuit configuration. So this is the step-by-step solution to simplify series parallel to solve the electrical parameters like resistance, current, and voltages. Okay, next. But we have some reminders here that the same current occurs through all series elements, the same voltage occurs at across all parallel elements, and remember that Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law apply for all currents, and then regardless of the whether the circuits are series parallel or parallel series combination, try to remember Ohm's law and Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. So what is Kirchhoff's voltage law? That the summation of all voltages in a closed loop is equal to zero. Meaning to say that the summation of the voltage rise is equal to the summation of the voltage drops. That is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Talking about Kirchhoff's current law, it is the in any junction, in any node, the summation of current is equal to zero. Meaning the summation of the current entering to that junction is equal to the current leaving in that junction. So that is Kirchhoff's current law. That the summation of currents at any junction, a node, is equal to zero. So try to remember that one, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. That is the two laws formulated by Robert Gustav Kirchhoff's. Ohm's law also is very necessary here. So, din lang tamo question. That is the law that is formulated by George Simon Ohm. Okay? So, we have this example number 15. Consider the circuit of figure below. So, as you can see here, we have these three resistors connected in series parallel combination. Why series parallel? Because what you are going to do here is you have to combine first R2 and R3. And then add it, or it will become in series with R1. So that is why this is called series parallel combination. So just an observation. Okay, your voltage source here is 45 volts. You have R1 is 12 kilo ohms, R2 is 10 kilo ohms, and R3 is 40 kilo ohms. So take note that your voltage that will be here at R2 and R3 are the same, because they are connected in parallel. So whatever the current total between I2 and I3 here is equal to I1, because this combination of parallel circuit is in series with R1. So therefore, your I1, which is your total current, is equal to the sum of your I2 and I3, because R2 and R3 are connected in parallel. So that is our few observations. Okay, so we have here our unknown. First, find the total resistance. Second, solve the currents I1, I2, and I3. And the last one here is the voltages V1 and V2. Okay, so V2, we are not required to solve for V3, because as we know that V2 and V3 are just the same because they are connected in parallel. So this is the thing that we are going to do. Examining the circuit, we see that resistors 2 and 3 are connected in parallel. So what you are going to do, try to combine this R2 and R3 and then add it or in series with total resistance R1. So, okay, just go back. Our R2 is 10 kilo ohms. Our R3 is 40 kilo ohms. Okay, so how you are going to do here? Well, what you are going to do, solve for the total resistance for this R2 and R3 connected in parallel. Once again, ito yung formula, R2 times R3 divided by R2 plus R3. That is the modified formula to solve for the total resistors, two resistors connected in parallel. So meaning to say that we have this 10 times 40, so we have this 400 kilo ohms, divided by 10 plus 40. That is 50 kilo ohms. Okay, so more or less, if you're going to use your calculator, that is equivalent to 8 kilo ohms. Then it is in series with R1, that is 12 kilo ohms. Therefore, the total resistance, according to our formula, is just simply equal to 20 kilo ohms. Total resistance is equal to 20. Add this R1 with the parallel combination of R2 and R3. Okay, so we have here 20 kilo ohms total resistance. Okay, to solve for using Ohm's law, we will be able to solve for the total current, where your total current according to Ohm's law is just the product or just equal to the voltage divided by the total resistance, or that is equal to 2.4 milliamperes. So the current I sub 1 will enter node B and then split between the two resistors R2 and R3. Okay, so we have, okay, this is new, maybe new to you, but I am not so sure if this is new to you. This is what we called as current divider. Okay, what is this current divider all about, class? So, kung current divider magamit na nimo, if we have this node, if you have this total current nga atong i-divide sa kaduha, duha ka mga resistors, then we have a short solution for this by using this your current divider. Okay? So as you can see, what is your I sub 2 if your resistance 10 kilo ohms for R sub 2, 40 kilo ohms for R sub 3? And of course, later on, what is your I sub 3? Okay. If this is your circuit, and then your total current is 2.4 milliamperes, as we solve here. So you can use here the what we call as the current divider. Solve for your I sub 2 with a total current of 2.4 and with these two currents, two resistances here, or solve for I sub 3 later with these resistors, and you can use this current divider. Okay, so in anira, ha? So I will give you an idea how to solve for I sub 2, for example, using the current divider. Now, your current divider is, or your I sub 2, I hope that you can find this solution. To solve for I sub 2 here is equal to the product of the total current times the R sub 3, the opposite of your current I sub 2, times the R sub 3 divided by R sub 2 R sub 3. Okay? So, niara. Kini, no? Monisya. Okay. So, I sub 2 is equal to the total current of 2.4 divide or times, no? I-times na ito ni siya with this factor. Ang opposite nga resistance sa ato ang resistor 2, which is 40 kilo ohms, balik tagamay, so that is 40 kilo ohms, okay, divide by the sum of these two, so that is current divider. So we have this total current times the opposite of 40 kilo ohms divided by the sum of the resistances, 10 kilo ohms and 40 kilo ohms. That is current divider. That is 1.92 milliamperes. Now, how to solve for I sub 3? Now, anyway, we have two ways of solving I sub 3. But using your current divider, you have your total current, okay, total current times the factor of the opposite resistance of 10 kilo ohms. Balik tagamay. Diri man ta I sub 3 man ato ang ginasolve diri. So ang atong opposite resistance is R sub 2, which is 10 kilo ohms. Okay, so we have this 10 kilo ohms divided by the sum of these two resistances, 10 and 40 kilo ohms. If you are going to simplify this one, this is just simply equal to 0.48 amperes. Okay, anyway, if you are going to sum up these two, if you are going to sum up 1.92 milliamperes and 0.48 amperes, this is just simply equal to 2.4. Why? Because according to Kirchhoff's current law, that the summation of currents at any junction is equal to zero, meaning the current that enters divide is equal to the current that leave to this junction. This junction point B We have the entering current of I total is equal to 2.4 milliampere. Then we have two currents leaving here. So therefore, na-solve na nato atong I sub 2. Another solution to solve for I sub 3 is by using the Kirchhoff's current law. I sub 3, therefore, is equal to the total current minus the leaving current of I sub 2, in which your I sub 2 is 1.92. So 2.4 minus 1.92, that is simply 0.48. So therefore, if you're going to take or find the sum of this I sub 2 and I sub 3, this is just simply equal to 2.4 milliampere. So that is, anyway, it just give you an idea how to prove that our answer is correct. Of course, we have to solve for V sub 1 and V sub 3 or V sub 2. They are just the same because they are connected in parallel. So we have the current 2.4 for I sub 1, which is the total current of 2.4 milliampere, times the resistance at resistor 1. So balik lang tagamay, ha? Because we were able to solve I total of 2.4, and that is your I sub 1. So muna itong gigamit dire, no? 2.4 milliampere. And that is multiplied by the resistance 12 kilo ohms, that is 28.8 volts. Then for V sub 3, that is 0.48 milliampere, the voltage, the current at resistor 3, and then multiply it by the resistors 40 kilo ohms. Or pwede sa diapon nga itong gamiton is our current of 1.92, pwede sad, no? 1.92, i-multiply na nato sa 10 kilo ohms, that is still 1.92 times 10 kilo ohm, that is still 19.2, or it is 0.48 milliampere, the current at resistor 3, and then multiplied by the resistance of 40 kilo ohms of resistor 3, that is just 19.2. That is that it is just a proof that your voltage V sub 3 and voltage V sub 2 are just the same and they are just equal. Okay, so this is, I think, the last topic of chapter 5. Okay, so we have this ladder networks. It is somewhat a complicated circuit having a series, parallel series combination or parallel series, parallel, so on and so forth. So, taas ka inisya, we have three branches, and in between is having R1, R3, and R5. We have R2, R4, and R6. So, the problem here is to solve for I sub 6 and B sub 6, no? For example lang. So anyway, we have according to ladder networks, we have two approaches how to simplify, how to solve for I sub 6 and V sub 6. Ang una nga solution is gikanta diri sa tumoy atong isolve ato ang total currents and total resistance. And after that, balik na sad ta dinhi sa tumoy to solve for I sub 6 and V sub 6. So this is what we are going to do. So, una sa tanan, if you are going to solve for the total resistance going to the source, then what you are going to do, consider this one, R5 and R6, they are connected in series. And R5 is 1 ohm, R6 is 2 ohms. Okay. So, tanawa ha, nga to biyang anon ani is kini naka-blue din, no? I sub 6 and B sub 6. So, R5 and R sub 6 are connected in series. Sum up this one in parallel with 6 of R4. Okay, so pila man eh? 3 in parallel with 6. So 3 times 6 divided by 3 plus 6. More or less that is equal. Mangupya na lang din eh. We have here, more or less we have these 2 ohms. Okay, this is 3, which is 1 plus 2. In parallel with the 6, this is equal to 2. And this 2, which is the total or equivalent resistance for R4, R5, and R6, will be in series with R3. Okay, so that is why this is in series with R3. 2 plus R3 is equal to 6. R3, yes, R3 is 4. So 2 plus 4, we have this 6. Okay, so kay 6 maning a combination diri. 6 maning a combination diri. And this combination is in parallel with R2. your R2 is equal to 6. So we have this 6 and we have this 6 here parallel. So nakita ninyo din eh, we have these two resistors connected in parallel and they are equal 6. So therefore, to determine the total resistance connected in parallel here is your resistance and then divide by 2, because if you can still remember, resistors connected in parallel, to take or to determine the total resistance, just divide the resistance by the number of resistors connected in parallel. So 2 sila kabuok, divide by 3. So divide by 6 divide by 2, then that is equal to 3. Now take note that this 3, the equivalent resistor here or resistance here will be in series with R1. So therefore, we have this 3 plus 5, your total resistance is equal to 8. So this is total resistance of 8. Okay, so from that, we can solve for the total current or the source current I sub S. So total current, ayang gamit there is I sub S, that is I sub S. So your source current, which is your total current, is equal to the source voltage divided by the total resistance. Okay, so according to the formula, we have our total power, our total voltage is 240 volts. So we have this 240 volts divided by total resistance of 8. And our total, our source current is 30 amperes. Na-solve na nato ato ang voltage nga, na given ang voltage nga 240. Na-solve na nato atong total current nga 30. Na-solve na nato ato ang total resistance nga 8. Then let's go back to the right side. So okay, our source current here is 30 amperes. We have this resistor 1, balik ta diri padulong sa tuo. Okay, our car resistor here at resistor 1 is 5 ohms. So atong solbon karon dili na laning R2 dinhi na lang ta sa R3, kay nga gipangita dinhi is katong tumoy nga I6 o V sub 6. So according to the okay, so to solve for I sub 3, that is very easy, because let's go back to the circuit that the combination we have here, the parallel combination of R2 and the rest of the combination 6 ohms, pareha sila dua. So we can say that since the resistance are the same, so meaning to say that this current I sub S, which is equal to I sub 1, will be just simply divided by 2. Aron masolve na nato, that is your I sub 3. And of course, this is also equal to I sub 3 din eh, because de pareha silang duha ka currents or resistances. So therefore, your I sub 3 here is 15 amperes. So kung pagtanon mo, pila man ni current nga musulod diri sa atong R sub 2, this is also 15 amperes because pareha silang duha nga resistance. So ato na po ning bungkagon ning atong I sub 3 o gato ang combination diri sa 6 ohms, bungkagon ta na siya. So we have this R sub 3 and we have this circuit here. Okay, at nibalik lang ta. So we said that I sub 3 is equal to 15. Okay, so your I sub 3 is equal to 15. So timanan ta na diri ha? I sub 3 is equal to 15. That is the same ka, this 15 amperes will be the current nga musulod diri nga side. Okay, so we can use this what we call as current divider. Okay, so we can use current divider class here. No, so what is the current divider? Do you have the total current that will enter at this node, which is I sub 3? That is your total current, and you have the resistance 3 here, and we have the resistance 6, B sub R sub 4 is 6, the combination of R5 and R6 is 3, but we are not so concerned with I sub 4. What we concerned here is I sub 6, muna ang ato ang ginasolve, so I sub 6. So again, we can use the current divider rule here. So therefore, your I sub 6, your unknown here, is equal to the total current nga musulod, that is I sub 3, divide by or times the opposite resistance, which is 6. So we have this 6 times I sub 3 here, and divide by the sum of these two resistances connected in parallel. So we have this 6 plus 3. So therefore, your I sub 6 is 10 amperes. So we were able to solve the total current, the current at resistor 6, which is equal to 10 amperes. And what is the voltage across resistor 6? Okay, so you have that current of 10 amperes and your resistance of 2 amperes. Now, question, you might ask class, you might ask, sir, ganong 2 mana siya? Dili mana siya 3, nga 3 mana na diya? Because this 3 here is the combination of R5 and R6. Now, what our requirement is to solve for B sub 6 only. So that is why your current of I sub 6 will be multiplied only to 2. Kay ma-appeal on niya ang R5 nga 1 kung atong i-multiply this one by 3. So our unknown is to solve for B sub 6. So therefore, you have here 20 volts. Okay, class? Okay, so we were able to solve for I sub 6 and V sub 6. Your I sub 6 is 10, your V sub 6 is 20. This is one of the longest solution to solve for the unknown using this ladder method. Now, let's proceed to another method. Kining lain nga method din eh, nga itong gamiton, magamit ta diri og mga iyahang mga liter, no? Ang mga unknown liter at ipambutangan ng mga litra. Okay, so right, for example, balik ta sa original nga circuit, no, ladder circuit. So we have this R5 and we have this R6. So ang unknown nato is V sub 6, atong unknown is I sub 6. So the voltage drop across B R sub 5 is V sub 5. The voltage drop across R sub 4 is V sub 4. Our voltage drop across resistor 3 is V sub 3. Resistor voltage drop across resistor 2 is V sub 2. Voltage drop across resistor 1 is R sub 1. So total voltage is also 240 from the original problem. So we have these assumptions here. Okay, so niingon ta kaganina nga kini silang R5 og R6 series. Okay? So, bot pasabot, nga kung what is the voltage drop at V5 and idugang nato sa V6, no? V5 and V6, that is equal to V4. Why V4? Because this combination of V5 and V6 is in parallel with V4. So, V4 is equal to V5 plus V6. Okay? So, muna yung una dire, ha? Dirita sugod sa pinakatumoy. So V4 is equal to V5 plus V6. Okay. So what is I6 therefore? So niingon man ta nga ang V4 is equal to V5 plus V6. So therefore your I sub 6 is equal to V4. Okay? Divide by the sum of these two resistances. Okay? Kay kini sila diri ang ato ang voltage diri is equal to V4. So this voltage here V4 divided by the sum of these two is just equal to I sub 6. Okay. So therefore we have this I sub 6 is in terms of V sub 4 over 3. What that is equal to 1 plus 2. So what is now I sub 4? I sub 4 is also V sub 4 over I sub 4, R sub 4. Balik ta dere. I sub 4 is equal to V sub 4 divided by R sub 4. That is from Ohm's law. So, according to Ohm's law, your I sub 4 is equal to V sub 4 over R sub 4. So, therefore, your V sub 4 is equal to V sub 4, your V sub 4, according to this first equation here, your V sub 4 is equal to the product of the resistance 3 times I sub 6. So that is why we have this 3 times I sub 6. And this R sub 4, according to the given, that is 6 ohms. R sub 4 here is 6 ohms. Okay, so therefore, your I sub 4, therefore, is equal to 3 times I sub 6 divided by 6 ohms. So if you're going to simplify 3 over 6, you have this 0.5. So therefore, I sub 4 is equal to 0.5 I sub 6. Now, with this value here, okay, with this value, kining a node using our kining a node dini using our Kirchhoff's current law. Our this node is equal to I sub 3 is equal to I sub 4 and I sub 5. Kirchhoff's current law. The entering current is equal to the leaving current. So therefore, I sub 3 is equal to I sub 4 plus I sub 5. Your I sub 5 is equal to I sub 6, correct? I sub 5 is equal to I sub 6 because they are connected in series. So therefore, we can see that I sub 3 is equal to I sub 4 plus I sub 6. Anong dili man I sub 5? Akong gingon ganina, I sub 5 is equal to I sub 6. So I sub 3 is equal to I sub 4 plus I sub 6. So muna siya dire. So muna siya, no? Kita na to. I sub 3 is equal to I sub 4 plus I sub 6. And then, what is I sub 4? I sub 4 here is 0.5 times I sub 6. So therefore, substitute it here. I sub 4, we have this 0.5 times I sub 6 plus I sub 6. If you are going to simplify this 0.5 plus 1, well, that is a 1.5 I sub 6. That is I sub 3. Now, solve V sub 3. Let's go back to the circuit. V sub 3. What is V sub 3 here? V sub 3 is the voltage across resistor 2. And what is this voltage across resistor 2 according to Ohm's law? That is I times R. I sub 3 times R sub 3. That is according to Ohm's law. That is your V sub 3. So V sub 3 is equal to I sub 3 times R sub 3. So your I sub 3 is solved here. We have this 1.5 I sub 6. And then multiply it by resistor 3, which is equal to 4 ohms. Simplify, V sub 3 is equal to 6, I times 6. Okay, as you can observe here from the beginning of our solution, we tried to solve for the rest of the parameters here in terms of I sub 6. And we will have it later as the advantages. So we have V sub 3. We have this 6 times I sub 6. Now, that is your V sub 3. If V sub 3 is with that value, then that is, we can have it here. Okay? So, the voltage here V sub 3 and voltage here V sub 2, so that we will be able to solve this. Okay, so what is V sub 2? Therefore, okay, balikan na to, ha? What is V sub 2? V sub 2 is the sum of this voltage drop here plus the voltage drop here. So therefore, V sub 2, okay, is equal to the sum of V sub 3 and V sub 4. We have here V sub 3 and V sub 4, that is V sub 2. Okay, so your V sub 3 is equal to 6 times I sub 6. Your V sub 4 is equal to, where is it? V sub 4 is, of course, here. V sub 4 is equal to the product of 3 times I sub 6. Okay, so this is your V sub 4. Naradiay. Okay, V sub 4 is equal to 3 times I sub 6. So substitute, simplify, we have this. V sub 2 is 9 times I sub 6. Take note, I sub 2 is equal to, V sub 2 is equal to 9 times I sub 6. So, from Ohm's law, what is I sub 2? Nasolve na to ang V sub 2. Nasolve po na to atong V sub 2. We have the voltage of V sub 2 is equal to 9 times I sub 6. Our R sub 2 as given here, R sub 2 is equal to 6. So, divide by 6. So, therefore, I sub 2 is equal to 1.6 I sub 6. Okay, so it seems like a complicated solution, but anyway, we have several advantages if you're going to use this for a solution later. So, we have this V sub 2 9 times I sub 6. We have this I sub 2 1.6 times I sub 6. Okay. So, balikan lang na to, ha. Unsa man di ining atong I total which is equal to I1. I total which is equal to I1 according to Kirchhoff's current law, that is equal to I2 and I3. Subo na ko, I1 which is equal to I total, the source current, is equal to I sub 2 plus I sub 3. That is Kirchhoff's current law. The summation of currents at any junction is equal to zero. Entering is equal to leaving. So, that is why we have this formula of I sub S or I sub 1. That they are just the same. this is equal to I sub 2 plus I sub 3 is I sub 3, where your I sub 2, as we found out, is 1.5 I sub 6 plus 1.5 I sub 6, simply equal to 3 times I sub 6. What is the voltage drop across B sub 1? That is, according to Ohm's law, the product of the current and the resistance. Or simply, I1 is equal to I sub S. So simply equal to I sub S times R1. Your I sub S is equal to, we have this, I sub S is equal to 3 times I sub 6. Okay, so we have this R sub 1 is equal to 5. So 5 times I sub S. So bantayan na to ni siya. B sub 1 is equal to I times I sub S. Okay. So, according to the circuit here, that your total voltage source of E, the electromotive force E of 240, that is equal to the voltage drop V sub 1 plus V sub 2. V1 plus V sub 2, that is your current voltage E. Okay. So, where that... from that, we can say that E is equal to V sub 1 plus V sub 2, where your V sub 1 is 5 times I sub S. Your V sub 2, as we found out in a previous slide, we have 9 times I sub 6. So therefore, if you are going to simplify, your E is equal to 24 times I sub 6. So therefore, your I sub 6 is equal to E over 24, or just simply equal to 10. And your V sub 6 is I sub 6 times R sub 6, simply equal to 20. Okay, class? Kita ninyo ang atong solution. Even though this is, it seems like a complicated solution, but as we end up our solution from left to, from the right to left solution of our circuit, pag-abot ng pagsangko na to sa source side, the voltage sa source side, pagsangko na to dito, we will be directly solve. We'll be able to solve I sub 6 at the same time, we'll be able to solve B sub 6. Okay. So, that is the solution. And it seems, as I've said, it seems that it is complicated. Now, nganong may yung co-class nga it is more advantageous. Complicated man, di pareha ka ganina. Paabot dito, sangko ta, balik na yun ta. And we'll be able to solve for I sub 6 and V sub 6. Okay, so it is a shorter solution, just a combination of series, parallel, parallel, series combination. Simplification there. Then, here, ano may yung kung ano, mas dali man siya nga sayon man, taas makaig solusyon. Mas advantageous. Class, inani akong pangutana. The problem is just asking for I sub 6 and B sub 6, and that is very simple. What if you will be asked, or I will ask you, what is the voltage drop across B sub 1? Okay, that's a simple question. What is the voltage across R sub 1 or solve for B sub 1, for example? Then it is now very easy. Okay? It is now very easy. Okay. So, what is I sub S? I sub S is 3 times I sub 6. So, therefore, if you are going to solve for B sub 1, then try to multiply this 10 amperes by 3, and that is 30, and multiply it by 5. Okay? 30 times 5 is 150 volts. So, that is V sub 1 is equal to 150 volts. So, it is very easy. Okay. For example, if you are going to solve for I sub 2, what is the voltage at the resistor 2? What is the current at resistor 2? And this is very easy. Why? Because we have already solved I sub 6. So what is I sub 6? That is 10 amperes. Multiply it by 1.5. And of course, we will be able to solve 15 amperes. That is your I sub 2. And it is very easy. So we found out individual currents and individual a parameter. Solve for B sub 2. It is very easy. I sub 6 is equal to 10. It will be multiplied by 9 ohms here. So 10 times 9, that is 90. And that is your V sub 2. What is your V sub 3? That is 10 times 6, that is 60. So therefore, your V sub 3 is equal to 10 times 6, that is 60. Okay, class, let's continue. So that is the, why is that, that is the reason why I said that this seems to be complicated solution is advantageous. Because we will be able to, along the way, we will be able to solve for these parameters. Okay? I sub 3, we can solve I sub 3. That is 1.5 times I sub 6, which is 10. I sub 4, we can solve also. We have this 0.5 times 10. So therefore, I sub 4 is 5 amperes. V sub 4. What is V sub 4, for example? That is 30 volts. Because that is I sub 6 is 10 times 3, that is 30. So V sub 4 is 30. So that's dili lang na siya mao class advantage. So na solve na nato atong individual currents, individual voltage, individual, and if you will be asked individual powers, of course you can solve individual powers easily here using this solution. Okay, so that's and the ladder method, which is the last topic. And that's end our chapter 5 class. Thank you very much. God bless. Keep safe. Keep healthy. Thank you very much. And we will end our class today.
Contribution to our nation.